Now we have a pretty nice, pretty basic content type with our own content part. And there is one little neat trick that can make it a lot more useful, and that's by turning it into a widget. Or rather, creating a widget content type with the same part and pretty much same everything. That's just a very simple thing, but immediately you will be able to use the same content type or a similar content type with the same content part in a variety of other cases. Namely, like in flow part, adding widget to a flow part structure as we have seen during the user-facing parts of this course, or by adding widgets into a layer. So, let's do that. We have our migration here already. And in our migrations class, we have created this person page content type. Now, a widget is also a content type. It's just a content type with the stereotype called widget. Stereotype meaning something like a category of content types. It's basically a label on content types that makes it possible to distinguish between different kinds of content types. By default, this stereotype is implicitly just content, and if you want to create a widget, then you have to set the stereotype to widget, and pretty much that's the main point. So let's actually do that. Now we can't really extend the create method of this migration class because we are already running this application, so we somehow have to change the schema. We have to change the content types, we have to add an update step to our migration class. Now, of course, while you are just developing something anew, you can just put everything into the create method. It's fine because you haven't deployed the application yet. There is no database for the application that you have to keep. You can just wipe everything every time you change something in the migration class, reinstall the website, and that's enough. But let's pretend that we have already published this module, we have already deployed it into an application. We can't just change the create alone, we have to write an update step. So that's what we'll do. An update step will be just a method in the migration class that will be executed if previous steps have previously already been executed. Namely, we will create an update from one method here that returns two. What this means is that in the create method, we have returned one. So this is version one of this migration. In the update from one method, we will do the subsequent step and we return two. So as you may have guessed it, we can then also add an update from two, update from three, etc. So let's add our widget definition here. And well, what I can do is that I can just copy paste the person page alter type definition here. Call this instead something like person widget. Widgets don't need to be creatable or listable, but we'll need the same content part. And we need to specify the stereotype. And we also need to specify the stereotype, which needs to be widget. Just like this. And now we have a widget. That's it. One more trick, still in the migration. Although now we pretend that we have already deployed this application, and actually the application is here with this database. I can just wipe it off now. The trick is that even though your module might be deployed somewhere, it might also get new installations. So in not in every case you want to run all of these update steps. Because what happens now if you install this module into an existing application that already had this module installed previously, and then you install the update? Like, the migration there will be on version 1, and then once you install the update from 1 will run, everything works, that's fine. What will happen if you add this module to a new application where it wasn't turned on before? Well, what will happen that create will run, and then immediately update from 1 will run. But that's kind of fine still. In the end, you will get the same result, but it's quite wasteful to do all these different steps. And in this case, this is not that big of an issue because we are just adding a content type. But imagine that in such migration steps, you can add tables, you can populate tables, you can drop those tables. So you can do a lot of stuff that you might not need at the end of all of these upgrade steps. So, long story short, the recommended way is to always keep the latest version of your schema in the create method. So when you are installing the module anew, then just the create method will run, nothing else. Even if you create dozens of tables in between all the update steps, and then you drop them, and you do a lot of other things that you later figure out you don't actually need, that won't matter because the create method will contain the latest schema. If you install the method anew, then nothing else will run, just the latest schema will be applied. So to do that, well, first of all, you have to add the latest schema to the create method. So I'm copying it over. And secondly, you need to prevent all the now unnecessary update methods from running. And for that, you can just return two. So, neat little trick. That's it. Let's see how this will look like, how the widget will work in the new application, or in the not new existing application, but the new widget. I will now go back to the admin area, and instead of trying to create a person page, I will now try to create a person widget, because that has the stereotype widget. We should be able to find it here under design and widgets. Yeah, so for example, we have content here, let's add a widget, and we have the person widget here. So let's also add it, why not? And widgets always have a title that's implicitly given, so we have to add some kind of title. We can add John Doe title or something like that, or sorry, John Doe widget. We can put it on just the home page to keep it simple, and then it's the same fields of the person part. So the name is John Doe, the birth date was something. It probably wasn't from the Middle Ages, but whatever. And everything else can be left as such. All right, let's publish it. So far, so good. Now let's also open the front end and see whether the widget is actually displayed. And yeah, it is. Here's our person. Same thing here than under the person page. Since it's the same content part, it's pretty much the same content type except for the stereotype. And that's how you can create a widget in like 10 seconds.